the most successful bands of the swinging 60s with a sound you just can't forget. Gary Puckett and the Union Gap were so popular that in 1968 they outsold a little band called the Beatles. Lead singer Gary Puckett is currently touring the country and we'll speak with him in a moment, but first we've got to revisit some of their biggest hits. Lady. Consecutive gold records, and you outsold the Beatles in 1968.
I don't believe that, but I'll take the badge.
It's in all the blurbs. That was the year the Fab Four released an album called The White Album, so that's quite a feat. Yeah. What did it feel like to be in the midst of that enormous success?
In retrospect, fabulous.
Okay.
It was just a lot of fun, you know. I mean, I was a huge Beatles fan, but there we were, young and bulletproof and, you know, ready to tackle the world, so... it was fun. We had a good time.
Speaking of young, when we hear a song like Young Girl today, do you think you'd be able to release that song today with those lyrics?
What's wrong with the words?
it's young it's girl, not underage girl.
Young girl. It's not about...
Well, the young girl was the one that led him to believe that she was old enough. And in fact, she lied to him. So he had to say, wait a minute, you told me you were old enough and you're not. Now, please, go away.
Is that something that happened to pop stars?
No. It happens to pop stars, yes. But that song was written as a... It was written for success, basically, not for any particular person.
Wow. That's right.
Just written for all young girls.
That's right. Anyone at home, all the protocols were correctly adhered to. now, forget the White Album. You were actually invited to play at the White House at a command performance for Prince Charles and Princess Anne.
That's correct.
At the invitation of the president.
Well, it was overwhelming in a big way and a lot of fun because we spent the entire day on the grounds of the White House and they allowed me to just walk around with my camera.
Really?
And take pictures wherever I wanted to. And if I got off the tracks, the Secret Service would come and say, you need to move back over there.
We've got this little video here. And this is the event. This is you.
That's me.
And
Richard
Nixon is in there somewhere as well, I believe. Is that right?
Yes, he is.
Did he dance?
There he is.
There he is. Rather staid. There he is, yeah.
What was that like? Because he wasn't a very rock and roll president, was he?
No. He was the older generation, but...
Looked like Ed Sullivan.
Yeah.
Was that weird? Did people, like, your base, I imagine, would have been the sort of people protesting against Nixon, but was it weird for you to be there in that environment with royals?
No, not weird at all. It was a lot of fun. It was just something that we were invited to do, and that was life for us every day, you know.
And the royalty?
And with royalty.
So you got to chat?
Yeah, we got to chat with Prince Charles and Princess Anne. Actually, on the same stage with us that night was the Guess Who. Because they said to Prince Charles, who is it that you would like to have as your musical guest? And he said, I'd like to have the Guess Who. So they asked Princess Anne, who would you like to have? And she said, I want to see Gary Puckett and Union Gap. So we were both invited, and the evening consisted of music from both of us.
Princess Anne is pretty. She was pretty. She liked her rock and roll, didn't she?
She was a rock and roller.
Yeah. Any stories?
No stories.
No. Okay. Just checking.
If I had them, I couldn't tell them.
Did Mick Jagger tell you any stories?
Now, you were very famous for the Civil War uniform. So give us all that background.
Well, okay. I had tried to figure out how we could... You see, 45 records, remember the little ones? Yeah, and they had a little sleeve.
No, I was told, but yeah.
We're told. the record had a sleeve that was black or white or gray or brown or whatever, and there were 400 or 500 records every month going out to the radio stations. So I wondered, well, how can you get a shot at a top 40? That's what the radio stations had. So we were all wearing the same clothes on stage, off stage, the bell bottoms and the, paisleys and tie dyes and all that. And so I thought, well, we've got to have a look. And I had always had an interest in the Civil War history of the U.S. So one day I said to the guys, I know what we're going to do. because I had grown up in the Yakima Valley on the east side of the Cascade Mountains in Washington State in a little town called Union Gap that I would hitchhike to when I was 15 to do my Saturday job. So I said, guys, we're going to dress in Union soldier outfits and call it the Union Gap. And they all went, what? Oh. But so it worked.
How did that go when you toured in the South?
We were afraid to go, actually. Yeah. We were hesitant.
Because you've got a Confederate flag there, even though you're wearing Northern uniforms.
No. Or is that... Oh, wait a minute. That is a Confederate.
The Stars and Bars.
That is. I never saw that picture before. Weird.
Wow.
Wow.
Is that trying to...
Kelly, I'm using some well.
They snuck that in on us, for crying out loud. That's funny. Well, when we, our first big show was in Birmingham, Alabama, and we thought, well, this is the South. How are they going to accept us, you know? So we got a great big Confederate flag, as you saw there, and we rolled it up. It was, you know, probably this wide, and we put it across the keyboards, and when we walked out, we unfurled the flag, and 6,000 people gave the rebel yell, and we were off and running, so it was fun.
Wow.
Can you still fit into those uniforms?
I have two of them from those days, and in 2016, I was on a tour in America called Happy Together. We did 47 cities, and I wore it.
Wow.
And I could put it on a little tight in the shoulders and under the arms, but...
Wow,
but
there's not many 60s rockers who could still do that. Right. And the legacy, of course, lives on because Donald Trump is today delivering the State of the Union Gap.
I like it.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'll be here all week. You're also, you had a really unique sound, a pioneering sound. You're one of the few bands in the 60s to actually use a full orchestra with the stuff you did. How hard was that to arrange? Were you classically trained? Did you have producers doing it for you? Did you do it all yourself? And how did you manage to get all these orchestras to come on the road with you and stuff like that?
We didn't use orchestras on the road. We had a very talented band, however. We had five guys in the original group, guitar, bass, drums, keyboards, and all of us could play other instruments. Right. We had two saxophone players as well. So we weren't able to do the orchestral sound then as good as we're able to now, but the band was capable of playing those records and sounding great. So it was all put together by a guy by the name of Jerry Fuller, who had written a song for the for Ricky Nelson. Actually, he wrote it for Sam Cooke, but Sam didn't want the song, and Ricky heard the song and said, I like it, let's do it, and it sold four million copies. So, it was a big success for him, and he was the one that was able to say, I like your voice, I like the idea, I have a song, let's go make a record, and he was the one, as the director of a movie or producer would do, would go and find all the elements to make that record. And
so he was like your George Martin sort of thing.
That's right. Yes, he was.
I mean, the disco was huge in there, but you weren't
but
disco.
That was a little later than us.
Yeah, yeah. But also, all these years on, did you ever think, I mean, we've got Mick Jagger doing his thing, this whole nostalgia, how do you view that? What do you put?
Wonderfully.
Wonderfully, clearly. But I mean, isn't it amazing that people are just loving this?
Well, and Young Girl was remade as a disco hit, wasn't it?
Young Girl has never really been covered. The only, there are two records or recordings of it, I should say. One was called the All Star Band, which never had any success with it, and a singer from America called Jerry Vale. Also recorded Young Girl. But mostly that song has remained mine alone because nobody wants to cover it, I guess. Or whatever, I don't know. But I'm glad that that we love the music of our youth because Australia is receiving us well. Mm-hmm. We're sold out every night so far.
Fantastic.
Well, you are here for a fantastic Australian tour, and if you would like to see Gary Puckett, you can head to Abstract Entertainment for tickets for Gary Puckett and the Union Gap. Don't miss it. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thanks, Gary.
Great to see you.